हर खबर पर रहना चाहते हैं आगे तो डाउनलोड कीजिए एबीपी लाइव ऐप।
पश्चिम बंगाल के गवर्नर जगदीप धनखड़ पहुंच गए इस वक्त प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के लिए और कल जेपी नड्डा के काफिले पर हमला हुआ था जिसके बाद इन्होंने रिपोर्ट भी सौंपी है गृह मंत्रालय को। बंगाल के डीजी और मुख्य सचिव को भी तलब किया गया है। 14 दिसंबर को गृह मंत्रालय में पेशी होगी डीजी और मुख्य सचिव की। इस बीच ये अहम प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस पश्चिम बंगाल के गवर्नर जगदीप धनखड़ की और लगातार जगदीप धनखड़ पश्चिम बंगाल के गवर्नर सवाल उठाते रहे पश्चिम बंगाल में कानून व्यवस्था को लेकर और कई बार ममता सरकार के साथ टकराव की स्थिति भी रही है और ये तस्वीरें आप देख रहे हैं। पहुंच गए हैं प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के लिए जगदीप धनखड़ और अब किसी भी वक्त वो अपनी बात मीडिया के सामने रखेंगे। नड्डा के काफिले पर जो हमला हुआ था उसी मामले में ये प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं पश्चिम बंगाल के गवर्नर जगदीप धनखड़ और अभी तक उम्मीद ये जताई जा रही है जो रिपोर्ट राज्यपाल की तरफ से सौंपी गई है उस पर केंद्र बड़ी कार्रवाई कर सकता है। बंगाल के डीजी और मुख्य सचिव को भी गृह मंत्रालय की तरफ से तलब किया गया है और तस्वीरें हम आपको दिखा रहे हैं जगदीप धनखड़ की और अब उनकी प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस बस शुरू ही होने वाली है और जो कुछ बंगाल में कानून व्यवस्था को स्थिति बनी हुई है लेकर उस पर अपनी बात रखेंगे पश्चिम बंगाल के राज्यपाल जगदीप धनखड़। जेपी नड्डा कैलाश विजयवर्गीय तमाम नेता उस वक्त काफिले में मौजूद थे जब उनके काफिले में फाल्टा इलाके में तस्वीरें भी एक तरफ हम आपको दिखा रहे हैं किस तरह से भीड़ ने पत्थरबाजी शुरू कर दी।
I would urge all of you, please maintain absolute silence. That will be decorous for either side. I would again seek your cooperation. Keep your mobile phones in silence mode. I'm always very happy to interact with the media because in democracy, the role of media is like that of a spine. If a spine weakens, democracy is bled. I need to indicate as to why I have chosen to address the media today. I am not concerned with day-to-day politicking. I am not a stakeholder. What political parties do, how well they do, how they do it. My role comes into play when I look at the oath I took on 30th of July 2019. And that oath casts constitutional obligations on me. And the obligations are twofold. It is my duty to protect, preserve and defend Indian Constitution. And democratic values, human rights, rule of law. Second, it is my constitutional obligation that I have to stretch to the ultimate limit to serve the people of the state. And I can serve the people of the state only when democratic values flourish. They blossom. Human rights are not capsized. Rule of law is not casualty. Constitution is not on fire. The Honorable Chief Minister, Mamata Banerjee, she is also under constitutional obligation. and our constitutional obligation is spelled out. And that constitution is, that prescription is, she will act in accordance with the constitution. She has to follow the constitution. She cannot depart from the path of constitution. Friends, the law and order situation in the state has been continually worsening for long, in spite of my to the Honorable Chief Minister, Police and Administration on numerous occasions. Sir. Police and Administration on numerous occasions. Distancing of governance from rule of law and constitutional parameters is to an alarming level, making it extremely difficult for me to conclude the governance in the state is in accordance with the constitution. The events that happened yesterday are most unfortunate. They are a slur on our democratic fabric. They shame the largest democracy on earth. In democracy, everyone has a right to struggle, to occupy space, to put forth one's point of view, and to do all this without at least being interrupted by the state actors. That did not happen yesterday. That unfortunately also did not happen at Siliguri. The protesters were intimidated at Siliguri, and the violators got all the support of the state actors. But what happened yesterday, it was an important day. This day was Human Rights Day. The entire world is celebrating human rights, their basic rights. They are the rights essential for civil society, democratic way of life in the state of West Bengal. These human rights were in flames yesterday. I take a very serious note of the statement that emanated from Honorable the Chief Minister. How can a responsible Chief Minister, believing in rule of law, believing in constitution, subscribing to rich Bengali culture, talk the way she did? I have tweeted. I have urged the Honorable Chief Minister, Madam, please reflect. Please think. Please care for a sense, grace, depth of Bengali culture. And withdraw that video. She is a symbol of struggle, the Chief Minister. She is a senior leader. She is in a second term of Chief Ministership. She is Chief Minister of a very important state. Her these observations against President of the ruling party in the center are most unfortunate. I am doing everything under my command to make a fervent appeal to her, to request her. A withdrawal will enhance her dignity. Withdrawal of this video with apology will raise her stature, will do justice to rule of law, constitution, and our rich Bengali culture. I am sure she will look into it dispassionately. The local MLA and the MP, I would appeal to them. Political events come and go. Let us not tarnish the fabric of democracy. Let us not ravage it. Let us not ruin it. Diamond Harbour MP is a second term MP, a young man. I wish he had not said what he said. He was talking about a person much older to him, occupying such a serious senior political position that was avoidable. He should not have said so. I am sure he will heed my advice. He has a long career ahead of him, many years to travel, many decades to travel. He must be part of a system of setting very high standards. I have enormous respect for Saugata Rai Ji. His statement has hurt me. He has gone on record why go to the constituency of Diamond Harbour MP. In the process, he has damaged the soul of Indian democracy. We cannot be so politicized to lose all sense of proportion. The higher we are, the more responsible we have to be, the more tolerant we have to be, and we have to bend like tempered steel. I wish these unfortunate events had not taken place, more so when the entire global community was celebrating the importance, ascents, and values of human rights. We were witnessing some of the most ghastly scenes. Friends, I am pained, and I wish to request and caution the Honorable Chief Minister. I am using the word caution because I cannot dilute performance of my constitutional duty. I wish to caution for one good ground. Talking of outsiders, what is meant by this? ये बाहर का है हम कहां जा रहे हैं संविधान की आत्मा से हम कितना और भटकेंगे, संविधान की आत्मा पर हम और कितना कुठाराघात करेंगे। भारतवर्ष में ये बात करना कि भारतवर्ष का नागरिक कहां पर अंदरूनी है, कहां पर बाहरी है, मैडम चीफ मिनिस्टर प्लीज डोंट प्ले विथ फायर ऑफ दिस नेचर, दिस इज टू डेंजरस टू बी एक्सेप्टेबल बाय एनीवन हु बिलीव्स इन इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, हु बिलीव्स इन रूल ऑफ लॉ। लेट मी इनवाइट अटेंशन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर टू द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन and mind you state of west bengal luminaries have great role in that, the one that came into being here is being preserved in the parliament, and what does that say? We the people of india having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. Madam, Bharat ek hai. Bharat ki atma ek hai. Bharat ki nagrikta ek hai. Ye jo khatarnak khel hai. Kaun bahari, kaun andruni? Aap isko tyag dijiye. आपने शपथ ली है उस संविधान के तहत काम करने की जिसका प्रीएम्बल मैंने पढ़ा है। यदि अगर आप इस रास्ते से भटकती हैं तो मेरे दायित्व की शुरुआत होती है। मैं आपसे विनम्र प्रार्थना करता हूं, गुजारिश करता हूं, भारत के महान प्रजातांत्रिक व्यवस्था पर संविधान की भावना के विपरीत कार्य कर इस प्रकार का कदम मत उठाएं। मैं मानकर चलता हूं मेरी बात पर वो ध्यान देंगे। कल के घटना के बारे में मुझे सुबह जब हालात का पता लगा चिंता होना स्वाभाविक, और मैंने प्रातः से ही राज्य के चीफ सेक्रेटरी और डीजीपी से संपर्क साधा। मैंने उनको डिटेल्स दी, मैंने उनको जानकारी दी, और मैंने उनको कहा कि इस प्रकार का घटनाक्रम, इस प्रकार के डेवलपमेंट्स अच्छे नहीं है। 8 बजे से पहले मैंने राज्य के महानिदेशक डीजीपी से दूरभाष पर चर्चा भी की, और मैंने उनको सब जानकारी देने के पश्चात चीफ सेक्रेटरी को मैंने सब कुछ भेजा। फ्रेंड्स, 8:30 बजे कल प्रातः राज्य के चीफ सेक्रेटरी ने मुझे मैसेज किया, आई कोट, रेस्पेक्टेड सर, अलर्टेड एंड सेंसिटाइज्ड डीजीपी accordingly regards. I took it as a well-meaning message कि मेरी बात का असर चीफ सेक्रेटरी पर हो गया है, उन्होंने राज्य के डीजीपी को अलर्ट कर दिया है और सेंसिटाइज कर दिया है। जब आधे घंटे के घटनाक्रम से मैं बहुत चिंतित हो गया, लगातार मेरे पास रिपोर्ट आती रही राज्यपाल की दृष्टि से, मैं चाहता हूं राज्य में अमन रहे, चैन रहे। जब भी मेरे पास कोई जानकारी आती है मैं शेयर करता हूं, ताकि समय रहते हुए हालात बेलगाम और बेकाबू न हो। जब ये हालात नहीं सुधरे तो बेबसी की हालत में 9:05 पर मैंने चीफ सेक्रेटरी और डीजीपी को ये लिखा, मैसेज किया, आई कोट, मैं उस दृष्टि में बात कर रहा था कि लोग बेपरवाह होकर बेलगाम होकर आपराधिक कृत्य कर रहे थे, मर्जी और झंडा उतार रहे थे, मर्जी और झंडा लगा रहे थे। मैंने मैसेज किया, आई कोट, आई एम श्योर दे द वायलेटर्स दे हैव इम्यूनिटी एंड प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ पॉलिटिकल फोर्स पॉलिटिकल पुलिस। आई सेड आई एम श्योर दे हैव इम्यूनिटी एंड प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पुलिस विद एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ पॉलिटिकल आउटफिट एज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल हेड। आई शेयर माई शेम विद यू और टू डीजीपी एंड सीएस एज इट इज ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ योर एक्ट ऑफ ओमिशन एंड कमीशन। फ्रेंड्स, ऑल दिस हैपेंड बिफोर द रियल इंसिडेंट टू प्लेस। कुड देयर हैव बीन मोर कॉशन? कुड देयर हैव बीन मोर अलर्ट? कुड प्रिकॉशंस नॉट हैव बीन टेकन? वेन योर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल हेड इज क्वेश्चनिंग यू एंड क्वेश्चनिंग यू टू एन एक्सटेंट कि आपकी पुलिस पॉलिटिकल पुलिस हो गई है, आप पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के एक्सटेंशन हो गए हैं, आपके एक्ट्स ऑफ ओमिशन कमीशन की वजह से एक भयानक सीन हो रहा है, उसके बाद दे वेंट इन साइलेंस मोड। एट 6:00 इन अ मीटिंग दैट वॉज प्री शेड्यूल्ड आई रिटर्न टू देम कि बहुत हो गया है, 2 महीने से आपको समय नहीं मिल रहा है, प्रांत के हालात बद से बदतर होते जा रहे हैं, कानून को चुनौती मिलती जा रही है, चारों तरफ भ्रष्टाचार का बोलबाला है, सरकारी तंत्र का राजनीतिकरण हो गया है, अपोजिशन को कोई स्पेस नहीं मिल रहा है, रिप्रेशन और क्यूलिंग ऑफ अपोजिशन ज्यादा है, अब मिलिए मेरे से। जब उन्होंने बहुत आनाकानी की, 2 महीने से कुछ नहीं कर रहे थे, आई सेंट देम अ फाइनल कम्युनिकेशन की मेरे से 12 दिसंबर से पहले मिली, वो कल मिले मेरे से। उनको निर्देश था, लिखित में निर्देश था कि जितने पेंडिंग मैटर्स हैं जिनकी व्यवस्था मैं करूंगा आपको, उनके बारे में आप अपडेट लाइए। और चूंकि कल का दिन भी एक भयावह स्थिति पैदा करता है, मैंने कहा उसकी रिपोर्ट भी आप लाइए। दे केम विदाउट एनी रिपोर्ट, दे केम विदाउट एनी इनपुट। आई वॉज शॉक, I was shamed. They are the senior most bureaucrats. They must have some sense of duty. And matters for which they have to give me updates are pending for more than 12 months. A very painful day in governance. They could not help me at all. In such a situation, to discharge my constitutional obligations, I was constrained to conclude that the present scenario in the state of West Bengal is that any political activity by opposition party is ruthlessly repressed and quelled with police assistance. That is always in the state, most unfortunately and alarmingly, in political mode, in support of the ruling party. Such oppression of the opposition from engaging in political activity climaxed yesterday when political activity of the president of a national party was so intimidated, interrupted. Are we in a situation that bonhomie with the ruling party, bonhomie with the ruling dispensation alone guarantees your rights? You can have no rights, no human rights, no democratic rights, unless you are on the right side of the ruling party, unless you are bonhomie with them. Is that not a warning signal for death of democracy? Does it not signal death knell of democracy? And democratic values, the enormity went to a level when in challenging tone, Diamond Harbour MP, the Honorable Chief Minister Saugata Rai Ji, take to that kind of discourse. Finding the situation alarming, as my constitutional duty, I have sent a report about the extremely disturbing developments that do not augur well for democratic values, that are antithetical to rule of law, that sound death knell of constitutional parameters. I have sent a report to the central government. I do not wish to share the contents of my report as part of propriety, but I would want media role, that media has a significant role to play in survival of democracy. If protesters cannot peacefully engage into their political activity and the state actors are in support of those who engage in disruption, then we will not have democracy. I cannot be party to this. I do not want people of the state of West Bengal, and I can assure them, they must not lose hope. Your governor will vindicate his oath, whatever it may take, come what may. Such situations will not be allowed to last. And I wish to send a message. I have sent several times. It has impacted many. I want to send a message to some bureaucrats who are integrated as stakeholders in the political field. They are frontline workers. They are getting paid out of public exchequer. They are using everything under the sun to act not as public servants, but as political workers. Take my signal in the spirit of law. This will not be allowed anymore. I have details of 21 such people. I do not wish to reveal the details. I don't want to be judgmental. I have written to the Honorable Chief Minister. As and when she will spare time, I will share with her the sensitive details. Some details I have already shared with the senior functionaries of the state government. Our democracy is too precious to be damaged by these people, handful of them, thinking they are low unto themselves and unaccountable to none. Their accountability will be enforced. It is a matter of time. They will know that music of law in the ears sometimes is very disturbing because it is pleasant only to the common man, not to those who engage in violations. How can a governor countenance a situation where for over a year I am not told what are the duties, obligations of Sarjitkar Purkashta? He is a state security advisor since mid of 2018. And Madam Rina Mitra, February 2019, she carries a designation principal advisor internal security. I don't know what her duties are. And friends, the government is being run by people like Mr. Purkashta and more than half a dozen such people who are in important pivotal assignments after retirement. I'm not against any post-retirement benefit. Yes, I wish to tell them, you all are public servants. You are being paid out of public exchequer. You are liable in law for your acts of omission and commission. And many of such omissions and commissions await my consideration. Not only with respect to Mr. Gyanwant, High Court held him what? I have written to the Honorable Chief Minister that the High Court categorically held with respect to him, and these are not ordinary observations. The observations of the High Court were to an extent that a finding was recorded he has violated human rights. A finding was recorded his acts were ultra vires constitution. And that finding of the High Court was approved by the Honorable Supreme Court. A charge sheet was issued. An inquiry took place. Report was given. Mr. Gyanwant Singh challenged the report before tribunal. There was failure. He went to High Court. He failed in the High Court. High Court gave two directives. One, the disciplinary authority must take a final view within 3 months. That should have happened in early 2013. And that promotion be in sealed cover. What does the governor want for more than a year? Has the disciplinary authority taken a view? Has the inquiry concluded in accordance with 1969 rules? If so, I would like to know who has overruled these High Court observations. I would like to know who has overruled a negative inquiry report. They don't give. Such a man who faced serious accusation at the hands of the High Court for violating human rights is a state ADG law and order. The governor is bound to be worried. I must know what is the premise of his promotion, two promotions in 2014, in June, July, and then in December, and of course thereafter. Friends, these are very serious things. The order of Madam Reena Mitra says she is appointed. Terms and conditions will follow. Have they been there? If they are there, why are you not sharing with the governor? Your claim that the government is sharing information, it is transparent, it is accountable. I am the ultimate judge. The Chief Minister has an obligation to share it with me. It is a duty under Article 167. I have brought today, I wouldn't bother you. Number of letters I have written to her. No response. Just no response. This non-responsive approach of the Honorable Chief Minister to the critical issues I have raised is a pointer that governance is not in accordance with rule of law. Constitutional principles are being outraged. But more important, this is cover-up for corruption, for nepotism, for favoritism. And that is why, when I wrote to the Honorable Chief Minister,
पश्चिम बंगाल के राज्यपाल जगदीप धनखड़ को आप सुन रहे थे, जो कल की घटना पर लगातार ममता सरकार पर हमलावर हो रहे थे और तमाम कारण गिना रहे थे। साथ ही उन्होंने ये भी कहा कि जहां पर संविधान का ठीक ढंग से पालन नहीं होगा, वहां मेरा रोल शुरू होता है। आगे भी इस बड़ी खबर से जुड़ी तमाम जानकारी आप तक पहुंचाएंगे। छोटे से ब्रेक रुक रहे, तुरंत लौट कर आते हैं।